Lapidotti Casco. Reskoski says it's a classic. I call it leverage, you're gonna think it's a pain in the ass. Looks like you're almost at the cargo ship. Get on board, climb the stack, and access the container with the car in it. Then bring the car to my people and we'll get it out of the country. Top of the stack. Climb up there and get the car.
Hey, what are you doing here? You cocksucker!
Motherfucker!
I'm reloading!
Fuck!
Whoa!
You're sure they're not following? Bring it in. Okay, now bring the car to my driver. Should be obvious, but we need this car in good shape to give to Reskoski. It's meant to be priceless. And our man's imminent place on the FIB most wanted list is gonna make him ineligible to make insurance claims. You understand? Look after it. Okay, looks like they're sending people after the Casco. You need to drop these guys before you bring the car back. Drop as in ice them, or drop as in lose them. I don't mind. His car. There's only so much damage we can blame on the exploit. Bloodstains, bullet holes, burn marks, they'll go under general wear and tear. Anything freaky is gonna be a problem. You almost there? My driver's been mainlining junk energy drinks and downloading soft rock classics for a 40-hour drive to Central America. And she'd really appreciate it if you hurried up and sent her on her way.
Taking over.
Hey, good work, people. Great job. Nice, we're still in business. Very well done. All of you. Very, very non-incriminating. Yes, that's the word I'm looking for. You know, it's ironic given we, maybe now's not the best time to discuss irony. God, what is wrong with me, you know? I'm usually such a high achiever, you know, for a criminal. So, before we remove Professor Rashkovsky from his unwelcome stay in prison, we've got to clean up a few other loose ends pertaining to the case. Yes, it's a killing, but no, it's nothing immoral at all. Just lawyers. Well, the professor's old business associate and two lawyers, but really it's all the same. I mean, I always say, if you can't kill a couple lawyers to bend the law to your will, then who can you kill, right? Oh, here they are, Gavin Van De Loop and Josh Sherman. Get them on the way to City Hall, get the documents they're carrying. The business partner is Dima Popov. Extremely rich, extremely paranoid, and extremely horrible. Don't cry for this guy, no one else will. He's renting a place up in Richmond Glen. Just him, and a huge security team. Get close to him, take him down, and after that we should be ready to go.
Stretch now. It's a two-horse race with two of you on each horse, the ass and the head. Horse one is going for the lawyers at City Hall. Horse two is on the business partner in Richmond. Sound good? Get moving. Horse two, your target is Dima Popov. Did I mention he's paranoid? Well, yeah, he's really paranoid. No one I know employs as many bodyguards as he does, and I know some people who need serious protection, mainly because I'm trying to kill them. You didn't hear that. Giving you pistols with suppressors to get the job done on the QT. Move slowly, take out the guards, and bring down Popoff when you get up close.
It's not paranoia. It's being prepared, stupid. Maybe that's why I'm not the asshole in the jail, huh? Yeah, okay.
If a guard sees you and sounds the alarm, Popov will run, and then you'll disappear, and he won't appear again anywhere we could possibly get to him, okay? So do it slow, do it quiet, do it right, and if you don't, put him down quick when he starts running. Team 1 took out the lawyers. Don't rush this. Stay low, stay quiet. Running. Forget the guards and take him down. The deposition has been secured. Target is down. Get out of there now.
Thank you.
Objectives complete. Good.